As is true in cello choir, if the music's too much, make it easier. Don't play every note. I'm not going to play every note. I guarantee you. So simplify it out in whatever way you can. Take on me. So we're just going to start. Let's start at measure 5, which is this loop section. We're going to just do this real quick again. Then we'll play. Then we'll have part 1 and part 2 come in for 4 times through, and that'll be our build into the beginning. You need a part, Sean? You all right?
Maybe.
I got it right here, bro. Pass that back to Sean there. All right, from the top. Not from the top. From measure 5, like I just said. Cello 3 and 4 to start. Okay. We haven't rehearsed this. Except for maybe the first couple of weeks. So it's been a while. From the beginning, from measure 5 to the new beginning.
So is it going to be improvising?
Yes. Yes, just keep looping and I will cue it and make. When we start playing. 3. We're going to play that 4 times, but I'll make it really obvious. So if you're just hanging on that A pad, just keep an eyeball up here, okay? Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, that'd be great. That was an oversight to leave that measure out, sure. 1, 2, measure 5, go! I'll probably give you a couple bars to start, Sadie. And I'd like Sadie to go by herself for a while.
Okay.
transition this into canon and G. So that note's not going to work when we hit this, and I don't know how to get out of that yet, but we will just, I have to compose that, I think. But pretty rad, nice hanging with us and the whole thing there. I should really hear a couple things. We want to rehearse just a few things. There are a few moments where we play all the same rhythm. And if I point it out, maybe we'll all know that. Measure 16, that weird thing that you got at the end, everybody's got kind of that same... Some of you've had... 1, 2. Kind of that 16? And the melody stops playing there too, so it should really punch out. In general, I'm hearing nondescript like rhythms. I'm not hearing descript rhythms. Like, it's like everybody's kind of saying the same thing at their own speed, you know? And so it's not really ga-ga-ga-ga punching out. Let's try measure 14, and we'll do it without the melody, and see if you can just make it really crisp. We'll try 14 a few times. I'll play the number 2 part so you can hear that, and then I'll play 3 and then 4, okay? So listen to me.
But everybody's playing?
Yeah, everybody's playing. Okay. All right, that's a great idea, Janet. Let's do part at a time. Second part. Part 2 only. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe C plus, something like that.
Wow.
14, 1, 2, same people go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we're gonna all get that together, that measure together. Let's hear part 3. Can we do it? I want to hear it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. Perfect. Cello 4. 1, 2. Cello 4, 14. 3, 4. That's better. Now we're just going to do measure 16 and try to get that to where it punches out. Okay, 16. Actually, 2 and 4, you play have the same part. So I should rehearse you all together. Let's have 2 and 4. Before we do that, before everybody, parts 2 and 4 at measure 14, please. 2 and 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Missing, definitely a big deal. Don't play on the downbeat of measure 15 of the third beat. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2 and 3. 1 and 2 and off. Bum 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 bum. That'll make it really crisp. That's all we're gonna play is measure 15, part 2 and 4 only.
15.
Measure 15 only. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and... Again, 1, 2, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Cool. Feels like it's a little late on purpose, but let's hear 16 now. Same people. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Try that again. 1, 2 and 4. Try to stick stick the and in there. I just got it all wrong. Three and four and. Measure 14, everybody again, please. One, nice and crisp. Three and four and. Can we put some dynamic in that I just heard at measure 34, 3, 33? Can we drop down into a piano?
It's more like a not subito, but a little decrescendo, maybe 2-beat decrescendo into the downbeat of that.
I have a really fine pen if anybody needs a pen.
In the measure or with the measure before, I would like one.
What?
In the measure itself, okay.
The measure before, 2 beats before the downbeat of the great. 2 beats down, but put a piano on that measure and then just come down to it. It won't be like a, you know, it'll just be like, So it's not super like, you know how I am about classical music. It's not. You got one of those turbo bows.
Oh, yeah.
Did you
get
that, bro?
Yeah.
Pencil
in? Yeah.
Great. 33 piano. That's really all you need to know, and then you feel it bigger. That's all. All right? That was much better, much crisper.
Yeah.
Let's do this one more time, and then we'll get off it. Let's go from the beginning. No, we don't need to do the beginning. Let's do the beginning again. Yeah, we got time.
The new beginning?
The new beginning. Yeah, it's only been 15 minutes on it. The new beginning, measure 5, please. Cello 4 and 3. Start. 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're gonna do one at a time so we can build it. Not even say Sadie. Let it settle. Let it settle like at least twice, at least 4 measures of just this before you get going. 3, 4. Just open A's, yeah. You're good. I didn't want the improvisers to start yet. Perfect. Love that note. Perfect. Don't do too much. Go slower. building. Even louder. Bring it up. Yeah. Last time. And that is awesome, and that is how we're doing it. Does everybody like it? Any other comments or suggestions or thoughts? Cool. Measure seven. Can everybody, instead of playing eighth, can we all change to 16th? Totally. If your part is already 16th, then you are. Then you are good. Go ahead. If you can play it cleanly, if you got it cleanly. How about just the first two beats as 16ths and then 30 seconds? Instead of one anda? I don't know. Does anybody know? Wanda anianda ana? I have no idea what she would do. No idea.
You just count to 32 each.
Yeah. Okay, let's go on for measure seven. Now with everybody playing 16ths. All 16ths. All 16ths. All right, one, two, measure seven, here we go. 3, 4. Thank you. right, freeze right here. Just keep it in your brain. Let's pull out Pachelbel Canon in G and see if this kind of works. Keep that handy because we're going to play the last few bars of that. The last few bars of that going into Canon in G.
Ah.
You don't have it? I have it for you.
Wow, this just so happens to be the next one.
Yeah.
A couple of copies.
It's going to mess with your brain. Does anyone else need it?
This is a crazy mashup. Wasn't this somebody else's idea? Was this? This may have been Mike's idea. I'm sorry? Okay.
Yeah, blame me on Mike. Sure. Okay,
cool.
Thanks.
So we'll have to figure out what notes work and which ones are changing. We could do that now or I could do it later. But here, let's just start at the beginning of it. Or maybe I can figure out right now. Can somebody, let's just have part four play and I'll play these parts and figure out what notes don't work. Okay? So part four. Third at B, C. Okay, pick up your pencils. We're going to add some notes. That repeated section that you are at the end, not of this piece, of Take On Me. Open up Take On Me. The last six measures we're going to change for everybody. Cello four will start there. You're just going to start playing the bass line for Canon and G. It starts at measure 7-0. When you hit measure 70, D, E, we can change. Then the next one is B, C, G, C, D. And then cello 2, you'll play. Take On Me cello 2. Take On Me cello 2. In measure 71, play a half note E instead of a whole note E as written. Play a half note E and then play a half note B.
What? 72 or 73? Is it 73?
71. Okay. I didn't say 71. Sorry. The second beat of 7, measure beat 3. Tell you what, I'll work all this out and we'll do it. No, okay. We'll do it right now. It shouldn't take too long. So
if we're playing the bottom line on cello 2, just switch to the top and then add in the...
Oh, and let me see. Let me see what you got on the bottom line, because I don't see those on my score.
We got on a G. Bottom line.
Are they just in octaves? No, they're not.
No.
Okay. Yeah, I'm talking, the one only one I can see, I guess, is the top line.
Okay.
So I'm talking about the top line. The bottom line, don't play the bottom line.
Solid.
We may come up some other notes for that. The first two are totally fine. You can probably improvise this if you want to mess around. Like, it just is Canon in G. You can come up with your own part, really. But this is what I suggest, okay? So cello 2, just to go through it again, it'd be B, D, and you're going to... going to change every note that doesn't exist this way. Then you have an E, and then a half note B, and then you're going to keep, instead of a D, that'll be an E now. E, then G.
You said B and then D?
B. I just write them down here. Now it'll be an E.
Okay.
So 72 is E and then G?
E and then G.
Okay.
G, C, D. Okay. So C. And then so you'll have E, E, G, E, and then F sharp.
E, G, E, F sharp?
Yep. E, G, E, F sharp.
So that's the F sharp in 73.
Uh-huh. 1, 2, 3, 73. That'll be, instead of a G, you're going to have an E and an F sharp. Okay. That was harder than I thought it was going to be. Scratch out now the last two measures. Everybody scratch out the last two measures. They're gone. No more shall there be last two measures. This is where the fun of cello choir is. Cello three.
Yes.
You're going to play the first three notes are fine. And then instead of a C, you'll play a B.
That's at 71.
That's at 71. The second note is a B instead of a whatever. C. Then you'll play a G. Now just stick with that G is good. Actually, no. Yeah. Play an open C.
For the first note of
72. Open C. Open G.
Okay.
Open C. And then open D. And cello five, I'm the only one playing one today, so I'll figure that out later. Can we go from measure 70 and just see how this sounds?
Sure.
Basically just going to be the beginning of canon in G. I might cut some measures out of canon G. Measure 70, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. It sounds like canon. Now let's see if that sounds cool, because this may sound stupid.
But then do we just go right into the canon G?
Yeah, then we're going to go right into it. We're probably going to skip the first two measures.
How many?
Two. Or we may even jump in canon G since it's such a long piece to like letter A or something like that.
Oh, wow.
We're about to figure this out. Okay, thank you.
But is the tempo going to move? Mm-hmm.
Be about the same. That was horrible singing. Let's go from 56 altogether, okay, everybody? 56 of Take On Me. 1, 2. What are you ready? 1, 2. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Measure 70, new notes. We may have to repeat that too. Let me pull up. I don't know yet. I don't know. That seemed a little like less subtle. I kind of want a one fader coming down and one fader coming up. So I'm not sure how to facilitate that yet.
I think if you play 70 more, like it's still
the same tune.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that, totally. That's kind of what I'm wanting to do. I think the B is what makes it messes it up. So if we don't play that B, we may be able to keep this going. So instead of...
And 71, that B?
Yeah, I'm trying to pull up Canon and G right now. Thanks, guys, for checking this out.
Sure.
Now we have a puzzle. All right, so I've got it pulled up. So how about this? Everybody hold through instead of changing... changing on that B, the second half of 71. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, Moira. Yeah. Oh, sure. Well, I hope so. Does anybody have a pencil?
Yeah, I have pencils.
Janet, coming to the rescue again. Molto pensales.
Estimulus.
No. Yeah. No. No. Good point, Marty. Thank you, Dana.
Yeah, the last two measures are out. What you're doing, the chain down. Did you get those note changes?
That's not a bad idea.
I gotta play teacher supply.
So don't play the B. Let's just see what it sounds like. The double bar at 70. Don't play the half. Just play a whole note in the second measure 71.
Okay.
That whole note that the new whole note that you've been given, if you've been given one, nobody has actually. Just hold that through. And then change the notes as we've said before. Does that make sense?
Is that for the note before that B?
Yes.
Turn that into a whole note instead of...
Right, yeah.
It's an experiment right now. We can all keep this in our brain. Beat 3 of 71, don't change notes. Just hold the note that you were playing previous for 4 beats.
I'm sorry, so that... you're playing the canon.
Wait, you told us to start playing the canon at 71.
So instead of playing the B, don't play the B, play just the E and hold it. J, D, E, another E, and then C, G, C, D. Yeah, that's for everybody.
So
measure 70.
Two separate notes or
just hold it. Hold it through. 71, the second half of 71, don't change notes. No reason to change it right now, but I think that's what's going to happen. We'll give it a shot. One, two, 70, yep. One, two, three, 70. Hold this note. Hold it. Hold it. Do that again. That's it. That's it.
That's really nice.
That's it. So we're going to play it twice. Put repeat signs around that.
Oh, okay.
And then when we get into it, we are now then going to jump to... So were you playing off of the canon part?
Yes.
Then just once the... Let's see, you'll play it twice then. If you're just going to read that... The double E twice. And then as normal.
Well, that would only be if you play the double E twice, that would only be all it is. It's 4 measures.
Are they quarter notes or are they half notes? Okay, so yeah, it would only be 4 measures in total. So the second half.
So twice you would repeat the E.
Right. G, D, E, E, C, G, C, D, G, D, E, E, C, G, and then just as printed. Cool, I think that's going to work. One more time for 56 of the previous... Yeah, so I was going to try. 56 of Take On Me into Canon.
And so we're skipping the first 2 or the first 4 measures of Canon?
We're going to skip until, I think, letter A, actually.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, let's get Canon going. Canon takes forever. As we learned last time. 56, please. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4. Transition. Did everybody have that ready to go? Is that possible to make ready to go?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yes! This is our first segue between pieces that we've ever done.
Yeah, that's cool.
Right?
Yeah.
We've talked about it many times, but this is the first one that I think is going to happen.
Maybe you shouldn't write Canon Ninji in the program.
I don't.
So that they're like...
Plus surprise. Set plus a little. A scroll?
A scroll?
Like, you know. You probably, that's kind of what my iPad's doing. It's just.
I was going to say, you could all bring iPads. But I think it would be more fun to have like a really long thing.
Accordion one? Yeah.
Have one that like comes down from the ceiling.
Yeah.
I was like,
so it'll actually go to half the tempo.
It goes to half the tempo, yeah.
I just realized, of course it would be slower.
Yeah, it goes to half the tempo.
I remember the really long mountain piece that we played. What was it? Not on Ball Mountain.
Yeah.
I had like 3 pages, and then I like taped 3 pages down.
I'm supposed to change tempos between.
You're doing it naturally. You don't even notice it.
So, for instance, I'm playing part 2. Take on me, and then I'm playing 4, which is just the.
So the half notes at the end of Take On Me
are
the same length as the quarter notes in Canon and G.
So I was supposed to be playing those slower.
I think you did it just fine.
I don't think so. I think I...
Did you go... Oh, yeah. You did then. You played it totally wrong.
So... Perfect. That's what I was hoping for, really. So that's... So it only then happens twice. No, it only happens...
No, there's going to be 2 holds. It'll just be in the second half of measure 1 and the second half of measure 3. Right? Beat 3 and 4 of measure 1.
Okay, now I'm super, super confused because I thought you just said that I was supposed to be playing each of the Pachelbel Canon notes for a half note. Yeah, the quarter notes and what part are you playing in Canon? 4.
You're playing Canon though, right?
So those quarter notes that we're playing over and over and over again are the same length as a half note in Take On Me.
The question is when you hit measure 70, do you jump to the new part or do you at measure 70 instead of playing 70 do you jump to Canon and G? Okay, then yes, that's where you slow down half speed with the quarter note, and you play a canon nice and slow.
The notes sound like they're the same.
You're saying that
they notes sound like they're the same speed, right?
But you said that the E was supposed to be held in measure.
Not for a half note now for you. G.
Right, so that doesn't happen until 71, which is what you said.
Right at 71, you're going to go right to canon and G and play G, D, E, and hold it. Second measure. Just like it's printed, and then, okay, cool. Well, let's put it away. I reserve Canon for a practice at a later session. How about, let's try Mr. Blue Sky. We always got to run it. Let's see if we can just run it.
Mr. Blue Sky.
super involved here. This is a fast four. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It goes by in a hurry. All right, everybody got your music spread out? 3 pages if you can. One, two, three, four. I noticed everything was going good until H. I get lost around H-ish. Sounded great though. Part four, you really jumped out there, and then letter H, part four, we need some, that rhythm's all messed up. I don't know, need to rewrite it or just learn it this way. Bless you. Let's go from letter G, I guess. Letter G? We missed you, Marty, for the first,
Yeah, I gotta tape it down
or slide. G, one, two, letter G, here we go, go! Thank you. pizzicato. Noticeably louder. Part one and two, keep playing your note. One, two, dun, 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 dun. One, two, three, four. Perfect. One, two. One, two. It's not too bad. The notes, it's a little too out of tune, I guess is the word.
Yeah.
175 till it stops being out of tune. So from 175 to like 181, we got to figure some things out and make sure that we're playing the stuff. Okay, so can we try that? 175, please. Digga 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 bum ba da da. Right there, 175. One, two, three. I guess we should probably hear our first notes. And I change cello four, open C, the whole measure. Sorry, measure five, cello five. Cello five, open C, the whole measure. Da, 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 da. Open C, the next measure too, and then open G. Da. Make sense, Pat?
Yeah.
Whole measure of C, 175, C, open C again. Those are the only two changes, then just as printed.
Oh, okay.
Instead of having the quarter note and that other thing, that lift, from 175, please. One, two, three, four, C. Do that together and have it sound even better. One, two, three, four. It's close. How about just cello two and four together? Two and four. Two, three, two and four. Yeah. No cello four, no cello five. Cello two and cello four at 175. One, two, cello two, cello four. So, yeah, good. The I'm even just get rid of it, but just don't be early on it. Make sure it's after beat four on that open on that A. Two, three, four. That's on part four. Now let's do that again, everybody. 175, two, three, 175. time, just that. I think we just need the practice. 75, 2, 3, 4. I don't know why. 181, please. 181. 2, 3, 4. Cello 2. Yeah, we're really just going to focus on cello 2 now. Let me just have me and cello 2. 2, 3, right there. 181. 181. D flat. 3, 4. Yep, 3, 4. Again, 3, 4. D flat, 3, 4. Try to get that in tune. It's a, no, it's not whole steps, but it's a scale that should be gorgeous and beautiful leading up to it. All right, put it away.
Well,
yes, ma'am.
Is
183 just an E? 183, yep. Woohoo! Nope, that's an F natural as well. Sorry about that. Yes, if you're part four, make a note, that's a second finger F natural at 183 downbeat. That is huge, actually. That's huge.
Did you hear any F sharps?
Live and Let Die? Is anybody playing one on this? Aside from me? Newest?
Living that die, living that die, living that die.
This is also a fast four. One, two. Let me hear your first note, just so we can get that going. First note. One, two. One, two, three, four. If you got a pencil handy, circle 15, 16, 17, 18, measure 18. Just blazing loud. please, as blazing loud as, I don't care if it's sloppy, I don't care if it sounds bad. I want that bow heavy. Yes, ma'am. Let it be there. Let it be out of tune. I don't care. Don't be timid. Don't be shy. And the only other thing, can we put a comma? I haven't asked for this yet, but measure 16 after you play that long. You'll hear off, and we all land on big old down bows. Okay? How y'all doing over there, part four, with that part? Five, I mean.
Five, yeah, get it.
Great. Okay, from, let's please do the beginning, what the heck? Beginning, that's the top. One more time, everybody. One, two, three, four. Did I say we're going to stop there?
Well, you said railroad tracks.
Railroad tracks, then that is a total stop. And I'll try to do it as quickly as possible, but I don't know how else we can do it. We all have to kind of stop so we can start together. That was pretty good with the break, but not good enough at measure 16. So I want to practice measure 16.
Oh.
So measure 16, yeah, so make sure you put railroad tracks and stop before 59. Don't play 59 without me. And measure 16, I want us to stop. Boom. Bottom drops out of the floor. Low frequency just. See that key and peel dubstep? Like that. Nose bleeding, just like everything.
I don't quite remember, but like, I have this concept and I think I've seen it before.
Okay, good. It's a little segment called dubstep. Check it out. I should send it to y'all, and I'll say that's what I want to measure. 17, 15 then. Da da da. It happens quick. 1, 2, 15. Everybody see it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow. I just really took off. I have no idea why. Try it again. Da da da. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. Good. Wrong. So that's another one. We need to have a comma at 72, 73, 74. After the note of 74 and in between 75, there will be a comma, a little break.
Sorry, where?
70. It's just boom. Yeah, da da ba da. Boom. If you know where that's at,
yeah,
it's an accented note. Just make sure you separate that from the previous note. That's measure 75. Don't play 75 without a break before it. It's a good way to put it.
Okay.
Yep, except if you got that. Yeah, da 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 da. Even there, there's going to be a comma. Ba da 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 da. Bum. So everybody, yeah.
Pretend you're like playing like a giant tuba and you gotta breathe.
Yeah, that's great, yeah. Measure 59, we kind of fell off the rails there a little bit. It's back to the original tempo, which is still a fast four. One, two, three, but not as da-da-da, ga-da-da. One, just a little slower. One, two, three, four. Change a note, cello two, the second to last note, you have a D. Instead of that D, just play, what do I have? Play another B flat. Okay. Da da dum bum bum. Sometimes I don't notice it until I play it with you guys. Does that make sense to everybody? We have a few areas we need to polish. I'd say, let me just hear cello two, and then we're going to play a little bit of Arabian dance to settle out the evening, which is kind of my favorite. Ching, ching. Tchaikovsky, so 59, please. Cello two only. It's like the ending of Zelda when you die. 59. Somebody ring that? One, two, three, four. Did I give that to you on cello two? It only plays me. It only shows me the top part, I guess. That was pretty good. Now without me. One, two, three, four. Perfect. Y'all promise to work on it?
Yes.
Thank you.
Gets a star.
That gets a star. A little star moment. Arabian dance, please. And this is all changed up, and I'm sorry for that.
Did you get like new extras?
No. It's just changed like verbally.
So we don't.
It's mostly in the lower part. Cello 5, I changed your part, right, to an open G or something? Okay. Pat, do you remember what I have for cello 5? And are there changes on it that you notice? No?
You said dance.
Okay, so cello five, you can play either the fourth finger G. I'd prefer you to play the open G, I think, actually. Just to get a little, yeah?
Do you have a violin cello two of Arabian Nights? I just want to see what it looks like. I just want to see what it looks like.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Just try the open G. I just feel like it's, yeah. Whole thing. The whole thing. That way you can rest. You can just play pizzicato on the... Cool. Well, when you don't have a G, then play whatever you got. So basically you can do that until letter C. Sound good? And then when it goes back to repeats, yeah, when it comes back to what it was before, just play that open G again. From the top? Sorry?
Am I the only one that has this start at?
Yeah, we would never do that.
Okay, it's formatted as weird. I think 9 is the measure below.
Oh. Oh, is that what you're saying? I thought you wrote in. So this is a bad formatting. Yeah, so 9 is, it's really, it goes with the measure above.
Oh!
It's dumb.
God.
Sorry about that. Totally. Nobody likes it.
All right.
That was my other change, is cello 4, we don't need to play the double stop. Let's just play because it's a little too messy. Yeah. G's and octave G's, that's all. That was the only change I remember. Do you remember you talking about that? Yeah, no? 1, 2, 3. With me? 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. There should be. I'll give it to you. Dun, dun, dun. 1. Dun, bum, bum, bum. Letter B. Pianissimo. Bum, 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 bum. 1, bum 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 bum, 1, letter C, my counting got a little off because I noticed a mistake in my part. Everybody good? Any other questions, errors, or whatever?
Would you say you said something 4 after A by adding a note?
Yes, cello 2. So you're going to play... it's going to be a G there instead of a half note.
25?
Yeah, where you have the rest. Is it 25? It's after A, fourth bar of A.
And so I'm sorry, there's A and then...
Rest, instead of the rest, play a G for a half note. Instead of a half rest, play a G. Make sense? Cello 1 at the same part. Letter D, please. Sounds beautiful. It really sounds great.
Yeah.
I need more.
Who else?
Regina. Who else?
Yeah.
Power. It's like a span. Yep. Yeah. Leapfrogging not, over to everybody. Like no. A nice at D. Here's a chance for you to hit those da 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 da's at D. 1, 2, 3, 3, 1. Dun, dun. That's the first one. 1. Did I give somebody the solo?
What?
Did I give anybody the solo on this? I'm mostly asking you, did I? No. Okay.
It is 8:30 something.
Oh my gosh, it's 8:32. Well, let's finish it.
Whoa.
From there, letter E, please. Let's go from E. 1, 2, sorry, honey, are you okay?
Yeah, I just have really bad allergies when the weather changes.
Yeah.
It goes insane, but it's not a cold
thing. Cool. 1, 2, letter E. 2, 3, 1. 1. Bum, bum. 1, 2. No, no, there's a measure S there for everybody, right? So let's go there. The fifth bar of E. Fifth bar of E.
Which is a rest.
Rest.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, G right now. G. Cello two only at the end. Two, one. One. Just get that in rhythm and. Thank you everybody for cello choir. I'm trying to do like a little backdrop thing. Duck it back. See you next week. I am not making it a rumor, but I kind of want to move to Mondays instead of Tuesdays. Please let me know if that's an issue. I know for you it's an issue. It's dreadful to me. But for this place...
After how many years?
No. I mean like in the future going forward.
No, I mean after how many years of playing on Tuesdays?
On Tuesdays for 10 years.
Really?
Yeah, 10 years.
It's been 10 years we've been on...
Yes, but that's been because Blackerby only had Tuesdays available instead of Mondays. For me, Mondays are amazingly worlds better. For this place, they're worlds better, too.
Fewer conflicts.
You matter a lot. What? That helps. Fewer conflicts of the church, exactly. Or I'll say this, what if there was like a schedule that was Tuesdays or Mondays on a, you know, a little, it is confusing, okay, A days and B days, all right. Just trying to brainstorm a problem to solve here. Trying to think of things to do.
You should send out a...
I'll send out one of the monkey... Chimp?
Don't think that's what you
Survey monkey. It's another...